listening to Worldview on WBEZ. I'm Jerome McDonnell, and it's time for Global Notes, our look at the world of international music. And Tony Sarabia, Morning Shift and Radio M host, is here. Hey, Tony.
You can't call me Tony Sarabia. You can call me TS.
Oh, really?
Why can't you call it Jim? I don't know.
I don't know. I think gymnasium, it's short for gymnasium. It's where you go to have sports.
Hey, I'm really excited. We have three young gentlemen here to the left of us. I'm surprised the window here isn't filled with people peeking
mobbing.
In.
Yep. Yeah. It is actually... Il Volo, the global phenoms, they don't get any bigger than this. These three young Italian men, they are still not old enough to buy beer, I think.
In Chicago.
Not in Chicago.
not
legally. They've been...
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno. And, I mean, they've been everywhere. They've been on American Idol. They've been on a public TV special. They've done tour dates with Barbra Streisand. They've done cuts with Placido Domingo. Tonight they are at the Chicago Theater. And it's just great to have you all here. It is three, as I said, three young men. Piero Barone and Ignazio Boschetto and Gianluca Giannoble. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you so much for me.
How is this Italian with your?
You know, you're one of the few that said correct our name.
I had some good coaching from a woman who is married to an Italian who you met earlier.
How many hours did you study?
Took me all morning, honestly.
Yeah, but you guys, your English sounds pretty good. Now, one of your albums, was it the 2012 album that you did a lot of songs in English?
Yeah, the last album, The We Are Love. Yes, the most of the songs they are in English, but you know, we love singing English, but we love singing in Spanish, we love singing in Italian, French, German, all languages, you know.
You know, speaking of Spanish, all of your albums come with a Spanish language edition. Why is that?
Because in Latin America, in South America, we are having a big success, and We decided all together to do a Spanish version of each album. And when we got in South America on tour, we got to sing Spanish. But we also sing in Italian because we are from Italy. And we are bringing the Italian name all around the world.
And then the people love when we sing in Italian, you know?
Yeah.
The people love that.
We had two nominations for the Latin Grammys and one for the Latin Billboard Awards.
No kidding.
Yes.
Was that a greater recognition than you've received in Italy in terms of awards? Like, have you been nominated for those kinds of awards?
In Italy?
In Italy?
No. You know, in Italy it's a different... Yes, we are famous, but not as much as we are here and in South America, you know? Because we were born in an Italian TV show, which was for young boys, you know? And so the people still see us like three children, you know, that sing with these voices. But, you know, the thing is, it's changed.
Yeah, but there are not that kind of awards so important in Italy.
Okay.
So Italy is just a little country and you can't compare Italy to United States or Latin America. Of course not.
Now, two of you are from Sicily originally, small towns in Sicily.
And yes, I'm from Sicily. This is Piero, and Ignaz is from Sicily too. And yes. Gianluca is from Abruzzo.
He's close to Rome.
And we are, the three of us are from a little town of 10,000 people or 5,000 people. Wow.
What is going on in these little towns that you want to do operatic singing? It would seem like most young people in the North America are really, you know, going for rock and roll and all that, and even small towns.
Maybe that's the power, the small town, because, you know, everybody helped to you to follow your dream, because everybody knows that you are a singer and it tells you, oh, try to do this or try to do that, because we are from a small town.
Yeah.
And maybe it's important to come from a small town, because when you reach the fame, you never forget where you come from, and that's really important.
Yeah, but it's really funny, because when I was home 5 years ago, nobody was singing.
Yes.
Now that we
really
did this, everybody sing. Everybody sing in the town.
No, but the most important thing is to come from a, you know, humble family and simple families, you know.
Because you remember that as you become famous.
Of course,
famous.
And the most important advice is that Barbra Streisand, Placido Domingo, gave to us was, and of course is, to work hard and stay humble, to be perfect work artist, you know.
We work hard.
But it's really nice because when we go all around the world and then after 6-7 months we go back home, it's like a party because everybody's excited to see again. And my little town is like my family.
You know, I got to say, you mentioned Ignacio.
Yes.
You know, young boys. But I got to say, when I saw you sing in videos, it's amazing because I have to say, Jerome, your voices do not match your faces. Your young
that's
age.
Maybe, that's maybe our particular thing, you know, because we are teenagers, but sounds like a man of 40 years old, maybe, you know.
Or a man in his prime.
And it's the first time that teenagers like us sing this kind of music.
And
so that's new.
We want to play some music.
Yeah, let's hear
and also, Lo Mio is the song that brought you to fame.
Your signature
tune. Yeah. And here you go, El Vola. There they are, Piero Barone, Ignazio Boschetto, and Gianluca Ginoble, Il Volo, and doing their signature song, O Sole Mio. And we're sitting here listening to it, and you guys are saying, hey, our voice, we recorded that 2 years ago, our voices changed.
Yeah, in which way, Giancarlo, have they changed? I mean, deeper still?
No, deeper. Yeah, they are. Yeah. Ignazio and Piero, they are two tenors, and I'm a baritone, so... Of course, the voices are changing because we are studying, and so of course,
it's getting better. It's getting better.
Right, it's getting better. Yes.
Now, even though this is considered pop opera, the three of you must really, or do you look to more traditional singers, historically famous in Italy, to learn?
We have different tastes, and we have different voices. So maybe if of course we are Il Volo, and we want to stay together singing operatic pop, but we have different voices. Maybe we can talk completely about completely different kind of music. For example, he sings a song of Placido Domingo during the concert. Ignazio sings Caruso, and I sing a song of Frank Sinatra. But just because we have three different voices, but when we sing together, it's beautiful when we sing in harmony. That's a beautiful sound because we have three different voices.
But I want to tell one thing. In the concert, in our repertoire, we don't have opera songs. We don't sing opera because lots of people say, "Oh, how do you know about opera?" Because we don't. We don't sing. We have to study lots of years. And now we are studying. I'm studying about opera, but right now I cannot sing opera. But I'm preparing my future.
But see, a lot of people, I think, would say to the contrary, hearing your voice is, wow, they sing pretty good opera.
Yes, we sing classical songs, of course. Yeah. Un amore così grande, O Sole Mio. We don't sing like pop songs.
Nessun Dorma.
It's not Nessun Dorma or La Bohème.
Mm-hmm. Now, who comes to your concerts? Do you attract an older crowd or do you attract young people?
It depends. Here in USA, the people are, let me say, 70% they are adult, and the 30% they are young generation, you know. But it's different in Latin America, which the 80% they are young generation, and the 20% they are adult. Yeah.
Yeah, screaming fans waiting for us outside the airports or hotels and singing our songs, full of people, 10,000 people. Teenagers everywhere, you know.
It's really funny,
and it cuts across generations. I mean, I think it was you, Ignacio, who said you were at a concert and a woman came because you got like to have the meet and greet afterward, and it was her daughter, and her granddaughter.
Yes.
This old lady. I don't want to say old lady. She was 82.
No, lady.
This lady came to with her daughter and her granddaughter, and she told me, guys, you got three generations.
Yeah.
And this was our goal, to bring this kind of music to all the ages.
What about in Italy? What's the fan base like?
In Italy, it's different because...
All ladies.
All ladies, but because everybody knows us in Italy, but they don't go crazy for us because maybe we were born in Italy. But our manager, Michele Torpedine, who is the one who discovered Andrea Bocelli, he had the same problem, not problem, but the same thing,
situation.
Yeah. Same situation with Andrea Bocelli, because he first became famous in the United States and all around the world, and then in Italy.
So what do you think of Silvio Berlusconi's singing talents?
You know, he's a...
Silvio is nice. Silvio is nice. He has a good voice.
Hey, Aerosmith also figures into your repertoire, right?
Yeah, I don't want to miss you think, but we sang it in a classical way.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's completely different. You can't recognize the song.
I know,
maybe
I couldn't.
Maybe it's the most classical song of the album. And, you know, our American manager, he was the Aerosmith manager. And when he
he's the one who discovered
Aerosmith, Steve Lieber. Yeah. And when he heard the song, he said, "Oh my God, I love this song. Who wrote this song?" And we told him, "This is your artist's song." Oh my God, I cannot believe it.
Yeah. Well, let's hear another tune. What do we have? Questo Amore here?
This is the Aerosmith song.
Mm. Let's do it. I do not want to miss a thing. Here we go. Questo Amore by Il Volo, and they're appearing tonight at the Chicago Theater and are spending a little time with us today in the studio on Global Notes with Tony Sarabia.
Actually by Aerosmith. And I'm sorry, I still look at you, Gianluca, and I can't put the voice and the face together. I mean, it's just amazing. It's a mismatch in a great way.
Now, is it true Barbara Streisand saw you guys on public television and said, yes, "Yeah, we want a gig with. I want a gig with these guys"?
Yes, we did a special PBS show, Il Volo Takes Flight, in Detroit Opera House, and she saw us on PBS and she told, "I want these guys in my show," and then her management called our management, and then we sang two songs with her in the show and two songs by herself, and we did 12 concerts all around North America and Canada.
What was
and
that like?
We've been here at the United Arena, maybe? No, wait.
United Center. And we sang at the Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles.
With her.
Twice.
Barclays Center.
Twice at the Barclays. Yes.
What was that like performing with her?
20,000 people each night, so yeah. You can imagine.
What's she like to her?
She's when I met her for the first time, I start crying like a baby, because you know my idol is Frank Sinatra, and for me it's the same thing. If you sing with Frank Sinatra,
but you know what? She does everything in a perfect way. She sings, she acts, she dies. She's the director, she's producer, and she does everything in a perfect way.
She's a diva.
It's amazing,
but a nice diva.
How do you guys,
of course, nice diva. Yes, in a positive way, of course. Yeah.
How do you guys see your careers evolving? Are you still hanging out and doing this together in 15 years?
You know, our goal is not goal, but we hope to stay together all the life, and because our power is when we sing all together, and so who knows?
But there's no desire. Probably not now, but you know, to try something solo,
no,
or side projects.
In the concert, we sing solo songs.
But I mean, like recordings.
Not
we think about the present, and we want to stay together because we really like singing together. And as I told you, when we sing, the harmonies, because we are so different. Our voices are complete. You can compare my voice to Piero's voice or Ignazio because they're so different. Different kind of music too.
Yeah.
But when we sing together, we sing the operatic pop. But as I told you, he sings Placido Domingo. Ignazio sings Caruso. You know, with a beautiful song that the most beautiful voices in the world, you know, have sing this song. And I sing Frank Sinatra, for example, no?
Yeah.
That's why we stay
all together.
As one.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on all your success. It is nice to see nice people doing well in life, and you guys seem to be doing great.
And you know what? We're so excited to be back in Chicago. We can't wait to perform tonight
at
the Chicago Theater, 7:30, because this is our third time performing here in Chicago in the same theater, and all the time is like the first time. So see you tonight.
7:30. Tony Sarabia, you're going to be laying some Il Volo out on the Radio M?
I could.
Play a cut, man. Thanks very much to Gianluca Ginoble, Ignazio Boschetto, and Piero Barone. They are Il Volo, 7:30 tonight at the Chicago Theater. Nice meeting you guys.
Thanks you so much.
Thank you. See you tonight.
Okay, no yawning.
No.
I was singing.